And now we will learn how to make a two-way line graph in Stata. A two-way line graph is appropriate when measuring or comparing two or more continuous variables. And it's just like we learned in school. One of the variables we believe is independent and changes by itself, and we would measure that one going across the horizontal or x-axis. Then the variable that we believe is dependent upon the first variable is usually measured vertically going up and down the y-axis. And when you plot each corresponding value from your independent variable compared to your dependent variable, you get a line that shows how the change in one will affect the change in the other. Here's the code. The red is the command, type in two-way line to tell Stata a line graph is what's following. Then leave a space, then type the name of the dependent variable, and then type the name of the independent variable. Now, in our example with this simple data set, this is exactly what we're going to type in. Two-way line is the command to tell Stata we want a line graph. Then snacks will be our dependent variable, and age will be our independent variable. What we are measuring is how many snacks people buy as a result of their age. Or you could ask the question, as a person gets older, do they tend to spend more money on snacks at the pool? So let's type this in. Two-way line, and then let's go back here to remind ourselves, snacks, which is the, we assume is the dependent variable, and age, which is the independent variable. Hit enter. Now here's the line graph that shows as one gets older, they tend to spend more on snacks. And more specifically, people who are 12 years old spend about $14 on snacks. People who are 10 years old tend to spend a little more than $10 on snacks. And people who are 16 years old tend to spend about $20 on snacks, and so on. Let's take a look at a second example. This is the code. How about we compare how age affects the enjoyment level of a person who goes to the pool? So we type in two-way line, and what was the code here? Enjoyment, age. Enjoyment, space, age. And this is what it looks like. It seems that on a scale of enjoyment from 1 to 5, people who are 10 years old tend to only enjoy the pool at a level of 2, whereas people who are 14 years old tend to enjoy it about twice as much. Now you may well ask, can you have more than one dependent variable in the same graph? In other words, can more than one variable be dependent on age, and can you put them together in the same picture? The answer is yes. And this is what the code looks like. You type in the same command, two-way line, type in the name of each of the variables that you believe are dependent on the very last one, the independent variable. So in this example, let's take both of the two previous examples and put them together in the same line graph. Here's the command, then enjoyment and snacks. And we're going to see one line that measures how enjoyment changes for age. And in the same picture, we're going to measure how snacks also change, or how dependent snacks are as it relates to age. So let's go ahead and type that in. Two-way line, enjoyment, snacks, age. And that's how you would type it in. Take a look at this graph. It's showing you that age is what's coming across here, and that the brownish line is measuring how enjoyment changes for enjoyment changes as age changes. And then this blue line, actually the brown line, is measuring how much they spend on snacks as they get older. And this blue line is measuring how much more they enjoy it as the respondents get older. And you can have several dependent variables in one line graph, but only one independent variable in the line graph. You can add titles to your X and Y axis for more clarity for the people looking at the graph. This would be the code. It would be the same code that you typed in before. Then you would put a comma, then add the text that's in green. X title, open parentheses, quotes, words that go across the bottom, close quote parentheses, then another space, Y title, open parentheses, quote, words that go down the side, close quote, close parentheses. The example we will do is, if we're doing two-way line for snacks and age, X title should be age of respondent, and Y title should be how, you know, the words spent on snacks. Now I've copied these, that exact text, and now I'm pasting it into the command line. If you copy and paste into the command line, you have to look carefully at little anomalies. For example, the beginning quotation marks here are missing for some reason when I did copy and paste. So I'm just going to put those quotes here. Again, make sure two-way begins with a lowercase letter. Almost all commands in Stata are lowercase. So now it should work. And when I hit enter, there's the line graph. And notice it says age of respondents, and it says spent on snacks. In fact, you can even add a label to the y-axis for scale. Now all you have to do is take the same code that you typed in a minute ago and add this bit of code next to it. You don't even have to put a comma. The only comma goes after the independent variable. Type it in just like this. So in our example, we will type in the command two-way line, the dependent and independent variable, then a comma. Then we will type in exactly this text in green for the titles of the X and Y axis. Then after a space, type in exactly this. And this will tell Stata the bottom measurement is 0, the middle measurement of the y-axis will be 15, and this time the highest measurement will be 30. Now, I already have copied this to my clipboard, so I'm going to paste it. And if you paste, again, you have to double check that everything pasted properly. If you like, you can pause the video and make sure you type in your line of code exactly like this, as it reflects the four different parts of the code for the four different things we need in our graph. When we hit enter, here it is. Age of respondent and money spent on snacks looks just like this, but you can see along the y-axis that this line starts at approximately 10 and finishes at approximately 20 because of the scale that we changed in the y-axis.